Have you ever wondered how the heck do entities work on the inside? Or maybe you want to add a new weapon to your mod, or a new NPC, or physics, or vehicles, or shaders, or a proper stealth system, whatever you can imagine. But there's a question, how to achieve any of that? One word, programming. Some people call it coding, some call it scripting. I call it programming. It doesn't really matter. Although if you don't know the difference, then that's going to be a bit of a problem, because as this tutorial series progresses, it's going to assume that you know about variables, data types, functions, arrays, pointers, and classes, basically the basics of programming. In the first couple of videos, I'll spoon-feed you entirely, walking you through basically everything, but after that, you will really need to know enough programming to be able to write something like, I don't know, a basic but a functional calculator in a console application or whatever. If you've done some game development in Unity, Unreal Engine, CryEngine, Godot, or any other game engine where you had to write code, this might be easy enough. However, there will be crucial differences. Most modern engines use an entity component system, whereas Half-Life uses a class hierarchy. So what this means is, in modern engines, an entity is basically an empty thing, and you put components into the model component, maybe a player input component and stuff like that, but in Half-Life that's a bit different. Each entity is sort of like a prefab in terms of functionality. Now there's one myth I want to debunk. Some people believe that it's most appropriate to use old tools to mod old games. In the case of Half-Life, especially when it comes to programming, this is so wrong. You see, 5 years ago, I used Visual Studio 6.0, which is an IDE from 1998, so it's as old as Half-Life, and it was just horrible, you know, and I'd never do that again. Modern versions of Visual Studio are just so much better. And there are versions of the SDK that are compatible with those latest versions, and it's just so much better. Debugging is better, writing code is better because of IntelliSense and stuff like that. So yeah, if you can, you should totally use modern tools. Since this is just the introduction, I'll show you three things. What you can do with programming in Half-Life, what is required to follow this series, and some additional resources for learning. For starters, here's some stuff you can do with programming. You can do, like, vehicles. That's entirely possible. It's got nothing to do with the engine itself. You can do graphical effects. So yeah, this means stuff like shaders. You can do time-dependent entities, such as, well, I don't know. Months ago, I wrote an entity called TriggerDate, which basically checks the current date. If it's like the 12th of November or if it's a specific year, then it's gonna trigger something. You can make new console commands. You can do that. You can change the view bobbing in Half-Life so it's gonna look modern, or player movement code so the player can sprint or maybe do wall running or wall jumping or whatever you can imagine, basically. So, what is required to start doing any of this stuff? First of all, you're gonna need something that can edit text. Whether you're gonna use an IDE or a regular text editor or even Notepad, it's up to you. On Windows, I'd recommend you to use Visual Studio Community. At the time of recording this stuff, the latest one is Visual Studio 2019. I know, it's big, it takes a while to download, and you need a decent PC enough to use it. So, if you can't use it, you can use Visual Studio 2010 instead. It's alright, I mean, I used to use it on my 2007 laptop. On Linux, however, you can use anything. Any text editor will do. Visual Studio Code is pretty neat. I haven't actually compiled nor programmed anything on Linux nor for Linux before, but I will cover that at some point. In these tutorials, I'm going to use Visual Studio most of the time, but almost all programming concepts will apply just fine on other platforms. Other than text editor, you're going to need some C++ knowledge. And this is already assumed. I'm telling you, if you don't know programming, do not try anything advanced like weapons, NPCs, and such. Please, do yourself a favor and spend a couple of months learning programming itself with C++. Now, speaking of C++ knowledge, and I mean knowledge in general, here are some nice resources. First of all, I would totally recommend Cherno's tutorial series on YouTube because I learned a good chunk of advanced programming topics and graphics programming and some engine programming thanks to his videos. There's more talking than there is code, and it's really good because he explains a bunch of stuff. Then there is the whole Half-Life. This is pretty much the place for gold source modding, where people still write guides and tutorials on the wiki, and they have what I would consider an active Discord server with quite some helpful people. The wiki also has links to archives of old VRC and Rust articles. VRC, or V-E-R-C, Valve Editing Resource Center, I think, was an extremely good website with some quality articles written by ambitious modders who worked on well-known projects at the time. Sadly, it got shut down in the mid-2000s. Next up, there is learncpp.com. If you like to learn things in a more traditional way, it's a pretty good place. Like, it's basically like a book with 18 chapters, and it's got like 5 to 10 lessons each, I think. The difference is, it's not a physical book, it's a website. If you are overwhelmed by the size of LearnCPP and you just want to learn something fast, to skim through it maybe, you can quickly go through C++.com's fast-paced tutorials. It's got 7 chapters, maybe 3 to 7 lessons each. Though it may leave you with more questions than answers in the long run, still, it's pretty neat for revising. I mean, that's how I kinda learned the basics of C++ when I was starting out with it. Then we have sourcemodding.com. Sourcemodding is a really neat website, which has a bunch of stuff for Gold Source and Source, and I think Source 2, not exactly sure. But basically, there are a bunch of links to tutorials and archives of old tutorials. Most of the Half-Life programming knowledge from the late 90s and early 2000s, you can find it there. Though a lot of that is kinda bad and just copy-paste, but still, it's better than nothing. Before I end this video, I'll just say what I'm planning to do with this series and what's the point. So, firstly, I'm gonna cover some basic stuff like creating new entities, setting up a mod, and so on. Then we're gonna do some more advanced entity stuff such as, well, I don't know, let's say an entity that flies around and follows the player and is breakable, which is, it sounds like an NPC, but it's really not. Then we're gonna do some client-side stuff like HUD icons, maybe view bobbing, and at some point we're gonna do really interesting stuff like file reading and file writing, so we can put, like, I don't know, some text file in our mod folder, and then the mod actually reads it and does something. It can be used to enhance the modding workflow. We've only scratched the surface so far. In the far future, we might even get to stuff like implementing a money system, or implementing vehicles, or graphics programming, which means shaders. Maybe integrating a third-party library such as a physics engine, and much, much more. So yeah, that should be about it for the introduction. As for why I've started this series, I felt like it was pretty necessary, especially in this day and age. Almost all tutorials about HLSDK programming are written. Some of them are badly formatted, and some people, to be honest, just don't really like reading. I personally do, but I know some people who just completely turn down most of the tutorials about Half-Life modding just because they're written. Video tutorials are cool anyway, since I can talk and explain something and then at the same time put up an illustration of what I'm talking about. And I was inspired by my buddy Dimbeek, who is working on a mapping tutorial series. He's pretty cool, you should check his stuff out. In the next part, we're gonna install some stuff, set up a mod, and write a very simple entity that prints Hello World into the console.